Hello everyone, I'm Kajal and today we are going to discuss the next chapter of the 10th class students. So today we are going to discuss the next chapter, chapter number 12, the endocrine system of biology. So let us start this chapter. Firstly, we will discuss about what is the meaning of endocrine. What do you mean by endocrine? Endocrine system is a system that is present in our body and that is responsible for the hormonal secretion, that is totally linked with that, and that is responsible for that. Now, what do you mean by the hormonal secretions and what are these things? You know that in our body the whole metabolic activities are continuously working, and due to that metabolic activities we are performing our day-to-day activities as well as we are working. How we are doing that metabolic activities in a proper manner or in a proper way, that is happen with the help of some kind of hormones that are secreting in our body. Hormonal secretions are there from the different glands, and that hormonal secretions are responsible for the digestion of our body as well as for our growth, for our movement, and for our and every work, even for our birth also. The hormonal secretions and hormones are there that are responsible for that. So a system that is responsible for these hormonal secretions, that is known as the endocrine system. So today we will discuss about that system in this video. There are two type of systems in our body, exocrine and endocrine. Now what is the difference between these two terms, exocrine and endocrines? Exocrine is a system that is also secreting some kind of secretions are there, but that secretions are due to the duct. They are the ductful glands. They are secreting their secretions through the ducts. But if we talk about the endocrine glands, these are the ductless glands, and they are giving their secretions directly to the blood, and from the blood that secretions are going to their whole body. Now which kind of secretions are there? Hormones are secreting. As I told you, I have used this term before also, hormonal secretion. Now what do you mean by hormones? Chemicals are secreting from these glands, and that are known as the hormones, and that hormones are responsible for our whole activities. So that are the hormones. So endocrine system is responsible for the hormonal secretions from different glands. Next one, if we talk about the endocrine glands, there are the different endocrine glands we will discuss in this video. First one is the adrenal gland, second one pancreas, thyroid, pituitary, parathyroid, thymus, and the gonads. These are the few endocrine glands that are secreting their secretions, and that secretions are responsible for our whole activities, metabolic activities as well as the other activities. I had shown you one diagram in which the whole glands as well as their pictures are depicted in that. Next one, firstly we are going to discuss about the adrenal glands. Adrenal glands, what is the location of the adrenal gland? Adrenal gland is like a cap, and these are caps are present on each kidney. So it is like a cap that is present on each kidney. This is the location of adrenal gland. In your exam paper, location as well as the functions are coming. So we are going to discuss that in detail. So listen it carefully as well as keep in mind. So that will be helpful for you in the examinations as well as for your when you will start solving your exercise, that will helpful for you then also. So adrenal gland, as I told you, what is the location? That are located on the as a cap on the each kidney. So it is present on the top of each kidney. Adrenal, if we talk about the adrenal glands are of two type. It is having the two types. First is medulla and the second one is cortex. The inner part is known as the medulla and outer part is known as the cortex, and there is the different secretions from these two parts also. If we talk about the adrenal medulla, the medulla is responsible for secretion of adrenaline hormone. What is the name? Adrenaline hormone. Now what is the function of this hormone and when it is secreting? This hormone is responsible for the for maintaining our body in the in stress as well as in the anxiety. Means whenever we are in the fear, flight as well as fright, in that mode also this hormone is secreting in our body, and it is responsible for regulating our body in that situation. When you are in the fear, then your heartbeat will increase. Why it is increased? Due to the in secretion of adrenaline, and that is responsible for that. And why it is happening with us? Because we are in the fear state at that moment. And which hormone is secreting? Adrenaline is secreting in that in that situation, and it is also known as a stress hormone. So adrenaline is known as a stress hormone, and from where it is secreting, it is secreting from the adrenal medulla. Next one is the adrenal cortex. Adrenal cortex is responsible for the secretion of the cortisone hormone. Cortisone hormone is categorized into two types: mineral corticoids and the glucocorticoids. If we talk about the cortisone hormone, firstly, cortisone hormones are responsible for the suppressing the inflammations. In our body, sometimes inflammations are there, but cortisone's work is to suppress that inflammations in our body. And as I told you, it is categorized of two types: mineral corticoids and glucocorticoids. Mineral corticoids are responsible for maintaining the mineral metabolism, especially sodium and potassium minerals. And if we talk about the glucocorticoids, that are responsible for maintaining the glucose level, fat and proteins in our body. So that is their work. Next thing is also there in the overgrowth of the cortex in the young children leads to the premature sexual maturity in them, because that is also linked with the secretion of sex hormones. So the increased secretion of cortex is also leading to premature sex maturity in the child. Next one, we are going to discuss about the hyposecretion and the hypersecretion of the cortisone. Now, hypo and hyper, what do you mean by hypo? Hypo means less secretion and hyper means more secretion. What is happening during the hyposecretion and hypersecretion of the cortisone? If we talk about these hormones, before starting this topic, I want to tell you one thing, that you know that the if we get the thing in the large amount as well as in the less amount, both are harmful for us. If we are hungry and we need two chapatis at that time, means we have the hunger of two chapatis and we will get only one chapati, that will also not be, in that situation also we will not be able to satisfy our hunger. And if we will eat three chapatis instead of two, then also it leads to the obesity. Like that way, the hormonal secretions lesser or more is also harmful for our body, and it leads to some kind of a disorders in our body. So firstly, we are going to discuss about the hyposecretion, less secretion of the cortisone. Hyposecretion leads to the Addison disease in a body. Now, what do you mean by Addison disease? There is one diagram we had shown you. What do you mean by Addison disease? Few symptoms are there. Addison disease is a disease in which the hyperpigmentation of the skin is there, as well as low blood pressure, weakness, weight loss. See, these are the few symptoms of this Addison disease, this disorder. Next one is the hypersecretion. If cortisone is secreted in a more amount in our body, then what is happening? It leads to the Cushing syndrome in our body. Now, what do you mean by Cushing syndrome? Cushing syndrome leads to the red and round face, as well as obesity, means the fat deposition is there in our body cells, so it leads to the obesity in our body. So both are not good for our body. So that's why the hormones are secreting in the normal amount. If it is secreting in a normal amount, that are good for our body. Next, we are going to discuss the second hormone, that is the pancreas. Now we are going to discuss the pancreas and its hormones. Pancreas, if we talk about the pancreas, it is known as the duct as well as the ductless gland. It is acting as a ductful as well as the ductless gland. How it is acting? As a ductful gland, it is secreting the pancreatic juice in our duodenum part for the digestion. So it is responsible for the secretion of the pancreatic juice in our duodenum part as a ductful gland. And if we talk about a ductless gland, as a ductless gland, it is secreting a special group of hormones that are known as the Isles of Langerhans. And these hormonal secretions are there. There are the different cells, alpha cells, beta cells and delta cells, and their secretions are different. If we talk about the beta cells are responsible for the secretion of insulin, alpha cells for glucagon, and delta cells for the somatostatins. First two, insulin and glucagon, is in our syllabus, but the somatostatin is not in our syllabus. So we will discuss about the insulin and the glucagon. So next one, glucagon as well as the insulin. Firstly, we will talk about the insulin. Insulin is the hormone that is responsible for the maintaining of the glucose level in our body. Glucose level, it is responsible for the glucose level. How it is responsible? Because it is absorbing the excess glucose from the body cells. But as I told you, under secretion and the hypersecretion of insulin will lead some kind of problems in our body. How it is leading? The oversecretion of the insulin leads hypoglycemia. Now, hypoglycemia means low blood pressure. Now, what do you mean by low blood pressure? Now, insulin is secreted in your body in excess amount. That means that insulin will absorb more glucose from our body. So, there will be lack of the glucose in our blood, and that will lead a disorder that is known as a hypoglycemia. And if it is secreted in the lesser secretion is there, means under secretion is there, then also it leads a kind of disorder that is known as a hyperglycemia or high blood pressure. Okay, high blood pressure means now the amount of the glucose is more in our blood because the insulin is lesser and they are not able to maintain the blood glucose. So that are the few disorders that is leading due to the under secretion and over secretion of the insulin. Now, second one, what is the function of glucagon? Glucagon is responsible for maintaining this glucose level. How it is responsible for maintaining this glucose level? Because glucagon is breaking the glucagon in the liver, and it is secreting again it in the blood, and by that way the maintenance of glucose level will be there in the blood. If there will be lack of the glucose, then also with the breakdown of the glucagon, it is maintained by our blood. So insulin is responsible to lesser the glucose level in our blood, and glucagon is responsible to raise the blood glucose. So that is their function, and they are performing their function side by side. Next one, we are going to discuss the next hormone, that is the next gland, that is the thyroid gland. Now, thyroid gland, and where it is present, what are the secretions? Thyroid gland is responsible to secrete two type of hormones. First is thyroxine, second one is calcitonin. In this chapter we will discuss about the thyroxine only, because that is only in your syllabus. Thyroxine, what is the location? Firstly, we will discuss location of the thyroid gland. Where it is located? It is located in front of the neck, just below the larynx part. Okay, just below your larynx part, and this is the bilobed gland, and it is present just below your larynx. What are the secretions of these ones? It is responsible for secretion of thyroxine. Thyroxine is responsible for maintaining the metabolic activities as well as the metabolism of our body. And there are hypersecretion and as well as the hyposecretion. Hyposecretion or hypothyroidism is responsible for maintaining some kind of disorder. First is the simple goiter, cretinism, and myxedema. And if we talk about the hyperthyroidism, that is responsible for a disorder that is known as the exothalamic goiter. I will show you the diagrams, and by that way I will explain you. First, hypothyroidism means now thyroxine amount in our blood or in our body is lesser. Thyroxine secretion is lesser in the blood. Then it leads firstly simple goiter. Now, what do you mean by simple goiter? Simple goiter is a disease in which the swelling of the neck occur in the person, in the patient's body. So in that, the swelling of the neck is there. I forgot to tell you one thing, that what is the main function of the thyroxine, thyroid gland, or as well as the thyroxine. Thyroid gland is responsible for the maintaining of the level of the iodine in our body. Iodine secretion is there, and it is responsible for maintaining of that iodine level. And due to the hyposecretion, means lesser secretion and more secretion, these kind of disorders are occurring there. So hyposecretion, we were talking about firstly simple goiter, swelling of the neck. Second is known as cretinism. Now, what do you mean by cretinism disorder? Cretinism is a disorder in which the dwarfism is there, means the person is not able to attain a specified height, normal height. Dwarfism is there. Second one, mental retardation, means the proper maintaining or proper development of brain is not there. So that are the few symptoms of the cretinism. So mental retardation as well as the dwarfism. Third disorder of the hyposecretion is the myxedema. Now, what do you mean by myxedema? Myxedema is a disorder in which the sluggishness is there. There will be swelling on the face of a person. I had shown you one diagram there. So swelling on the person's face, as well as the redness is there on the face. So that are the few symptoms of the myxedema. Third one is the hyperthyroidism, means excess thyroxin hormone. It is responsible for the exothalamic goiter. Now, what do you mean by exothalamic goiter? Exothalamic goiter is there in which the bulging of eyes is there. Here also I had shown you one diagram, but in your book also one diagram is given. There is the increased metabolic rate as well as a protruding eyes, shortness of the breath. So these are the few symptoms of the exothalamic goiter. Next one, we are going to discuss the fourth one gland, that is the pituitary gland. It is also known as the master gland of your body. Why it is known as the master gland? Because it is responsible, or it is responsible for maintaining the whole hormonal secretions. So the hormones that are secreting the different secretions, these secretions are controlled by the pituitary gland, and that's why it is known as the master gland. This question is also coming in your exam, that why it is known as the master gland. Next one, what is the location of it? It is located at the base of the midbrain, just below the hypothalamus. So this is the location where it is present, at the base of the midbrain, just below the hypothalamus. It is of two type, anterior and posterior pituitary, anterior lobe and the posterior lobe. Anterior lobe, if you talk about the anterior pituitary, it is also secreting some kind of hormones. First is growth hormone, second one thyroid stimulating hormone, this is also known as TSH. Third one, gonad stimulating hormone. Fourth one, adrenocorticotropic hormone, ACTH. Now, growth hormone, as the name is telling whole meaning of this hormone, what is the function of this hormone? This hormone is responsible for maintaining the growth of a person. Okay, growth of a person, if it is secreted in lesser amount, then it leads to the dwarfism of a person. And if it will be more, then the person height will be more as compared to the normal body. Here I had shown you one diagram in which the two persons are standing there. One is the very short and one is the very taller one. Hyposecretion of the growth hormone leads to the dwarfism. And there is a one diagram or one example of the He Ping Ping, that is very short in the height. He is a person that is very short. Next one, hypersecretion of growth hormone, and that example is Sultan. Sultan is having a height of 8 feet 1 inch. And if we talk about the He Ping Ping, it is having the height of 2 feet 5.37 inches only. So that is the difference. So if growth hormone is secreting in the more amount, then it is leading to the tallness, and if it is secreting in the lesser amount, it leads to the dwarfism. Next, thyroid stimulating hormone. As the name is telling the meaning, thyroid stimulating hormone, it is responsible to stimulate the secretion of a thyroid gland, means thyroxine. It is stimulating that hormonal secretion. It is also known as a TSH, and it is you know that the thyroid gland is responsible for the maintaining the metabolic activities or metabolism of our body. Next one, gonad stimulating hormone. Now, gonad stimulating hormone is responsible for the gonad secretions, means from the testes, sperms, as well as from the ovaries, the ovas or the ovaries. So that is responsible for that stimulation. Next one, adrenocorticotropic hormone, ACTH. ACTH is responsible for the regulation of the activity of the adrenal cortex. Adrenal cortex, from the adrenal cortex, that hormone is secreting, and that is regulated by ACTH. Next, we are going to discuss about the posterior pituitary. Posterior pituitary is responsible for secretion of two hormones. First is antidiuretic hormone, EDH, as well as it is also known as vasopressin. Now, second one is oxytocin. First, antidiuretic hormone. What is the function of antidiuretic hormone? Antidiuretic hormone is responsible for maintaining the glucose level in the body, as well as for maintaining the reabsorption of the water in the body. If it is secreted in the means in the normal amount, then it is responsible for maintaining that work. But the deficiency of the EDH causes the diabetes insipidus. Now, what do you mean by diabetes insipidus? It is also known as the water diabetes. Water diabetes means more prone to urinate, as well as the persons are urinating at the frequent times, and they are means while urination, water is coming out, thrust is there due to that urination, and that is happening due to the antidiuretic hormone, deficiency of the antidiuretic hormone, and this diabetes is known as the diabetes insipidus. Second one is oxytocin. Now oxytocin is a sex hormone that is secreting, and what is the function of this one? It is responsible for the contraction of the uterus in the pregnant mother, and it is also leading to the birth of a baby, as well as it is responsible for the ejection of the mother's milk after the birth of the baby. So this is the functions of these hormones. We have discussed about the four hormones and their functions, and this is also only in your syllabus. Next one is, one more topic is given there, control of hormonal secretions. As I told you during my teaching also, control is needed of the hormonal secretions. If hormones are secreting in the much amount, that are also leading some kind of disorders of inner body, and if these are secreting in the lesser amount, that are also leading some kind of a disorder. So secretions or their maintenance means control is needed, and that is also controlled by in our body, that are of two type, negative feedback and positive feedback, that are controlled by the hormones. So this is all about our topic, our chapter. Hope you understood everything, and the whole question answers you will get from the video only, because we have discussed each location, function and everything in the video. If you have any query, then again comment me by the comment box. Hope you understood, hope you like my video or my content. Thank you very much.